So if your records show that on a certain date, messages were opened all the way up to that date on Teresa Halbach's phone, that would mean that somebody had listened to those voice messages.
I'd like to be heard outside the presence of the jury.
Mr. Kratz?
He's about to show her some retrieved voicemails on the 2nd. If Mr. Buting's position, if his theory of defense is that Teresa Halbach is alive on the 2nd of November, we're entitled to know that. We're entitled to notice of that. That's my objection, is that it's irrelevant.
Mr. Kratz may draw the conclusion that because messages are opened as of November 2nd, that means that Teresa Halbach was alive on that date. I don't. And I don't think the jury needs to either. But I do intend to introduce records that show that her voicemail was picked up at 8 a.m. on November 2nd. Something was going on with this phone in a very, very critical period of time for this trial, which is between October 31st and November 5th when her car was found, or November 3rd when she's reported missing.
How does that help this jury decide who killed her? That's what the jury's here to do, Judge.
Because unless the state's prepared to establish that Mr. Avery had her password, then he's not the one who's listening to her messages on Wednesday, November 2nd at 8 a.m. So and their theory is that he's already destroyed the phone.
Never said he was.
Somebody who knew her, somebody who may have had a motive that he doesn't have, and somebody who may have had opportunity was doing that.
Sounds like
I'm not suggesting that she was still
alive.
Third-party
liability, Judge.
Yeah.
That's what it sounds like.
I don't...
Now, I'm not going to argue that part to the jury, because that's what the court says we're not going to do. But as far as what's relevant is, the police have had this report, and the police have not followed up to find out what's up here.
Does the state know who accessed the voicemail?
I suppose we could. If there was an inkling that Mr. Buting was going to suggest that Ms. Halbach was alive at that time, this is something that could have been looked into investigatively. It's another thing that we could do, Judge, if the defense is changing its theory.
This is not changing the theory at all. This fits perfectly to show that they have not followed up this investigative lead, because this investigative lead points elsewhere than Mr. Avery. And here we are in the middle of the trial and it hasn't been investigated. The jury has a right to know that.
All right, I guess having trouble seeing the apparent relevance of it at this stage of the trial. Let's bring the jurors back in.